celebrating our connection with our pets. This is Animal Radio. Here are your hosts, Al Abrams and Judy Francis.
And Judy's screening your calls at 1-866-405-8405. Was that slow enough for you, Guido? Dr. Dibby answering your vet medical questions. Vladdy, the world-famous Russian dog wizard. Dog father Joey Villani and animal communicator Joy Turner all here at your beck and call. And Stacy Cohn working hard in the newsroom.
There was a dog in Louisiana who actually was like half dog, half wolf. And he was given the execution order. Oh. They were going to kill this dog, euthanasia, because he was termed violent by his neighbors. He was a bad dog of the neighborhood. His name was not Leroy Brown. But anyway, he got a second leash on life. Huh. And I'll tell you how. He's going to prison, though. I'll tell you about it coming up on Animal Radio News.
Huh. Okay. Joey Villani, what are you working on today?
I am going to talk about how to get rid of those dead skin cells off your dog's skin and coat. Healthy coat, baby.
Hey, I saw you on Rumor Has It. They're running that in reruns now on Animal Planet.
They're running season two in reruns, which is good because I like the way I look better in season two. We had more production values. You know, they made me look a little bit better, a little thinner at the time. Very good.
Well, speaking of thinner, how much have you lost?
I'm still at about 58 right now.
Plateau?
I'm slowed down. Yeah, mm-hmm. But we'll get over that.
Both you and Judy are suffering from plateau syndrome.
I know. I hate that.
But look at Judy. Look how good she looks.
You both look really great, by the way.
Yeah, but it's just frustrating. Well, I think you look better.
Coming up on the show today, of course, the season of stars continues with Gary Burghoff, Radar from MASH. You remember Radar? Those of you
absolutely.
Too young. Well, MASH was a big series for those young kids. I think it was like one of the most viewed series in... Vlade, you've seen MASH, haven't you?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, so you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Gary Burghoff, who paints nature and is a big animal lover. I believe he has several cats, will be joining us in just a few minutes. Vlade just popped open a new bottle of vodka, and I understand that in Russia it's an insult if you open a bottle and you don't finish it.
It's the biggest insult if I'm not sharing it around, so let me try it.
I'm going to pass.
I think I'll pass. I'll wait till after the show. But I know that
I'll have some.
I'm going to stay with my tea.
You know what? The first time today I brought in the studio organic vodka.
Organic vodka?
See, yeah, my wife is crazy when it comes to everything organic. We don't have any chemicals in our house. We ripped our carpet. We put the hardwood flooring. And, we're really living green style of life. And you know what, guys? This is amazing. I cannot tell you enough how better we feel and how Mika is better because the pets is always on the floor. And when using different chemicals and cleaner and all the things, we're damaging ourselves, damaging our pets.
Mm. And this goes for the same for your dogs and cats and all of your animals. In fact, Banfield had a report this last week saying the biggest cause of death for animals is now cancer, 80% cancer. And this, could be from all the crap that we're feeding them, that, the cheap stuff that we think we're saving a bunch of money, but it's just crap.
Yes, and I would like to bring our listeners' attention to the new trend in the health industry. It is alkaline water. Before it was just available from Japan, they sell in the United States a system which you can set up under your sink for $5,000. Now Americans came up with the great product, which is better than them. I'm surprised, but they did it. Better than Japan.
Do you know? Again, was that another little dig that you didn't know why we've done it better than Japan? Was that another?
Why.
No, I'm asking you.
I'm very surprised why, and maybe you know the answer, but, because Japan is on the frontier of medical research and technologies when it comes together with the medical research. We in Russia very respect Japanese people. We don't like them too much. We like more Chinese people, but a different story.
Oh, send your letters.
Cut them off. Cut off the mic.
@animalradio.com.
Okay, we're going to go back to the phones in just a second. 1-866-405-8405.
The opinions expressed here are Vlade's only and not that of Animal Radio.
You're right. Oh my gosh, we have a fun.
This is Animal Radio.
celebrating our connection with our pets. This is Animal Radio. Here are your hosts, Al Abrams and Judy Francis.
And animal communicator Joy Turner, dog father Joey Volani, Vlade the world famous Russian dog wizard, and Dr. Debbie all here at 1-866-405-8405. I stand corrected. Dr. Debbie is, right now she's giving a cat an enema. Is that correct?
Yeah, she couldn't make it to the studio. She's going to be a few minutes late. She has all the fun, I tell you.
She really does.
just a quick reminder. I mean, she giving enema and probably the dog will have diarrhea. Look, I yesterday fixed one eating the poop issue by provoking diarrhea in the dog because dogs don't like to eat. Yeah, but it's worked. And a few times you give the dog something so the dog poop liquid and now she didn't want to eat her poop.
Enjoy your breakfast, folks. Stacy, jumping up and down in the studio.
Oh, I wish I could have been here to see this. This bear was stuck up in a tree.
Oh.
And the only way they could get him down was obviously with a tranquilizer dart, but they had to use one of those bouncy things, you know, that they use for kids' birthday parties.
Oh.
They put him between two bouncy houses. And they got him to go out of the tree and come down. And I'll tell you all about these firefighters and what they did coming up on Animal Radio News.
Yeah, that was on it was on YouTube or
that was cool.
On Facebook or something like that.
It was very cool.
Yeah.
I'm glad it wasn't the Russian bear. Otherwise, tranquilizer will not help, you know. You probably need to give him vodka. Here's the vodka bear. Come down.
Vodka seems to be like a cure-all. Like it's an antibacterial. You use it to wash your hands.
Well, here in the States, it's duct tape and WD-40.
Yeah,
in Russia, it's just vodka.
Yeah, that's what Americans would love to hear. They will never complain us if we hear that.
Let's answer some phones. Before we do that, I want to tell you this portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by Veterison One-Step Wound and Infection Spray for hot spots, cuts, scratches, and even rashes. You can reduce your pet's recovery time up to 60% with Veterison. For more information, head on over to veterison.com. That's VETERICYN.com. And which line have we given no attention to today?
Two.
We're going to line two. We have Bob. Hey, Bob. Boy, two Bobs in a row. Hey, Bob, how are you doing? Oh, I'm sorry. I got to press that button. Hey, Bob, how are you doing?
It's Todd. It's pretty good. How are you today?
Very good, Todd. What's on your mind?
Okay, what it is we purchased this little small chihuahua. She is 6 months old, and okay. She weighs 2 pounds.
Aww.
And the thing about it is my wife's wanting to put her on heartworm medicine, and I've heard through rumors that the small dogs like that don't need to be on heartworm medicine, and I don't really want to be taken advantage of.
Oh, that's bull pucky. I'm telling you, a dog's size does not make them immune to developing heartworm disease. So, no, this baby needs to be on heartworm preventative. What part of the country are you in?
Mississippi.
Oh my God!
All
yes.
Across the country, they go with us on the truck, all three dogs, and they are out here. And that was another thing that kind of concerned me.
Yeah, no, especially if you're doing cross-country traveling. The American Heartworm Society has actually published statistics that shows that all of the 50 major states do have heartworm disease, differing exposures and incidence of disease, but this baby needs to be protected. And I'm not afraid of her being 2 pounds. Fortunately for the dosing range of most of these products, they start at 1 pound and go all the way up to maybe 25 as the first interval. The important thing to know with the heartworm preventatives is that the dosage, say for a lot of the common ivermectin-containing products, they're actually in micrograms, which are a thousandth of a milligram. So we're talking very small, low doses. So this isn't likely to be a problem, even for a two-pound dog. So I am not worried at all. I want to get your baby protected. And listen to your wife, for God's sakes.
Oh, yeah, okay. Well, you know how it is. You hear a certain thing. I wanted to hear it from a professional.
Well, you know what the answer always is to your wife. The answer always is, yes, dear, sorry, I was wrong. That's always the answer.
The answer is happy wife, happy life. That's what the answer is.
You know? I agree with you 100%, but see, she is not here right now, so she doesn't know I'm asking.
Oh, yeah, sir, there.
Let's do that. No problem. The thing is we also have another chihuahua.
Okay.
He's all male. Oh, my gosh. Is he a male?
Oh, you meaning he still has those two little brain cells between his legs?
Yeah.
Why keep buying those chihuahuas?
Anyway, the thing is she's 2 pounds and he's 7 pounds, and if they mate, will the puppies be too big?
No, not necessarily. Now, the thing to know that 2 pounds to 7 pounds is a pretty close range. Now, if you were saying that her boyfriend was going to be, you know, a German Shepherd, I'd be a little worried. But also, when we look at certain breeds, Chihuahuas, especially some of the real Applehead Chihuahuas, sometimes just being a Chihuahua, they have a big domey head. So just being a Chihuahua could pose a risk for troubles during birth and delivery. Other breeds like Bulldogs, Boston Terriers also have kind of big round heads. So they can get stuck in the birth canal irregardless of the size of the father. So before you do make that commitment to breed, and we do not advise breeding, there's oodles of dogs in the shelters. In fact, in Las Vegas, almost 50% of the dogs in our shelters are Chihuahuas. So we don't need more of them. We don't need to make more as lovely as they are.
Sue would make such pretty puppies, see, because she is black and white and has a little gold in her tan.
Aw, she sounds lovely, but you know what I'm going to tell you is that every day, gorgeous, lovely little black and white chihuahuas are put to sleep because everyone keeps breeding these babies. So I would have to say I'm not a fan of breeding these babies. If you do need to do it and you feel compelled to do it, make sure you do consult with your veterinarian. We need to have these babies up to date on their shots and be prepared for a possible C-section. And that's the one thing people aren't always ready for.
Yeah, there's health risks there.
Well, and, you know, cost, too. I had a family, they weren't prepared for a C-section. They thought it'd be a great experience. And then, you know, $1,500 later, they're like, I can't afford this. Well, great reason to spay and neuter. So think about that, Todd. Just my little commercial message there. And I wish your babies very well and hope they're doing good. And get that baby on Heartworm Preventative right away.
Thanks for listening there, Todd. We appreciate it. 1-866-405-8405. Bet he didn't expect that barrage there when he called.
Yeah, I mean, and you, Dr. Dave, insulted my German Shepherd. She just told me I would never make it with Chihuahua. I would get a real dog for this type of activities. And you may be not a great fan. I'm not a great fan of them because of behavior problems. Most of them nuts. They biting everyone, barking nonstop, have separation anxiety.
Was there a period after that sentence? Just a few minutes away from Gary Burghoff, will be joining us for our season of stars. That's why. And boy, just an amazing season of stars. Brought to you by the Litter Robot, which automatically cleans the cat litter for you. It reduces odor, and customers report it cuts their litter usage by half. You don't need any special supplies or plumbing. Just use your favorite clumping litter and never scoop dirty litter again. Can you imagine that?
No, that would be so fantastic.
We know you'll love it so much. We offer a 90-day guarantee. Available at litterrobot.com. That's litter-robot.com.
Hi, this is Elaine Boozler on Animal Radio. Stay and neuter your pets and some of your exes.
You're listening to Animal Radio. You can learn more at animalradio.com. Log on. Learn more.
Vetresen, a one-step wound and infection spray that works naturally with your animal's immune system to aid in the healing process. Vetresen reduces recovery time by up to 60% on hot spots, cuts, scratches, and even rashes. Vetresen is non-toxic and will not sting and is safe for puppies and kittens. This safe, easy-to-apply product makes caring for your pet's wounds or infections easy. For more information, go to Vetresen.com. That's Vetresen.com.
There's no doubt that it's a great time to be alive. Our grandparents could only imagine smartphones, GPS tracking, robotic vacuums, and the litter robot. Yes, I said the litter robot. Technology that automatically cleans the litter box for you. No more nasty litter boxes to stink up the house, and always a clean, safe place for your kitties to do their business. It's so efficient and earth-friendly that you'll use half the litter, saving both time and money. And the litter robot doesn't need any special waste receptacles, chemicals, or plumbing. plumbing. Just use your favorite clumping litter. This is how it works. 7 minutes after your cat uses the litter robot, the patented litter sifting system automatically empties the waste directly into a bag-lined waste drawer, leaving a clean bed of litter for the next use. We know you'll love it so much, we offer a 90-day guarantee. You're on the cutting edge of technology, so why are you still cleaning the litter box the old-fashioned way? Step up to the self-cleaning litter robot, available online at litterrobot.com. That's litter-robot.com.
What dog food is specifically designed to reduce the risk of cancer, settle digestive upsets, reduce scratching and shedding? Canine caviar. What dog food reduces red tear stains and hot spots? Canine caviar. What dog food has probiotics that reduce the chance of soft stools and have a higher calorie count for better nutrient absorption? Canine caviar. So what are you feeding your dog? If you didn't answer Canine Caviar, visit caninecaviar.com today and get your pet started on a longer, healthier life.
Of Animal Radio is brought to you by Stella and Chewy's Natural Goodness for Dogs, made with raw USDA inspected meat, raised naturally with no added hormones or antibiotics, just the way we like them. It is the official food of Ladybug the Studio Stunt Dog, and you can learn more at their website at stellaandchewys.com. stellaandchewys.com. Of course, we link to that from animalradio.com. And we go to line one. I'm vetoing your decision here, Judy. I'm going to line one where we have Edward on the phone, and he wants to talk with Vladdy, the world-famous Russian dog wizard. Good afternoon, Edward.
Good afternoon to you.
Hi, Edward. How are you?
I'm good.
Good. You enjoying our shows?
I do, all the time on our radio, local radio station in Clinton, Iowa.
Okay.
KROS, good station, thanks.
Yes.
Yeah. So how can I help you?
Well, my question concerns my daughter and my son-in-law's lovely dog, Minnie.
Minnie.
It's a rescue dog.
Okay.
And they rescued it at about 1 year, maybe a little past 1 year. And they've had it
breed?
Now. The dog is five.
What breed?
Well, it's a mix. But
tell me.
What best way they can tell is, this is kind of the scary part and what I'll tell you later, but it's part bulldog and it has part mastiff in it. So it has a huge mouth and a strong mouth.
It's a becoming scary part for me, too. I'm not expecting to hear anything good after that. So bite me. Give me that scary part after that.
Okay. Well, the dog is a great family dog for the two of them, but the dog is not at all friendly or accepting of other dogs. Very, very aggressive to other dogs.
Okay, and my quick question to you, because I'm so sorry again. What is your name again? I'm so sorry.
It's Edward McMahon.
Edward, I will call you Edward. Edward, every time when somebody calls me and telling that story, I understand that people believe this is the unique story, and Vladdy never heard, never seen that stories, but I am passing the step doors when I go to my clients for thousands of times in five countries around the world. For me, it's just open book. And when you tell me about the certain things, I kind of visualize. I basically visually enter your house. I already see that dog. I'm serious. I almost sleep in my car because I have a 3 months waiting list for the people who wants to get me. I have people come to me from all over the state, staying in hotels, shipping their dogs to my boot camp. So I'm immersed in this situation. So I need just ask you the few questions. Question number one: did your dog bite, or is already bite anyone else?
As far as I'm talking about my daughter's dog, who lives in Anchorage, Alaska, and I have visited with them, and the dog has come back.
It was where the cerebellum was in charge. That's the state.
What's that?
The cerebellum, who is the great expert in Russia. That's what I mean. She was in charge of that state. That's the state of Alaska, yeah?
Yes, the dog lives in Alaska.
Okay. Okay, so you have no idea. So the dog, you don't know if the dog bit someone or not, yes?
I would guess. Well, I'm not going to guess. I'm pretty sure from any conversations I have with with her and with my experience with the dog. The dog has never bitten a human.
Wonderful.
That we know of.
What about dog? Did she bite another dog?
She, yes.
How bad?
I don't think there was ever a situation where the dog was left alone long enough to cause a great deal of harm. But
No. Hold on. Dogs can bite each other if you are with the dog in the dog park or you meet another dog on the leashes. If the dog got into the dog fights in those situations, do or not?
I would guess that the dog, from what I've heard and from little experience I've had, the dog will definitely be aggressive to any other dog that comes within its premises.
Okay, so let's make bottom line. Of course, I will give you a few scenarios because it's. I understand it's not your dog. You don't know all those details. So what I was trying to get information, if you would tell me, well, because sometimes people believe if the dogs act aggressively on the leashes, they believe that they're going to bite and kill. Well, that's sometimes not true because when you are holding the dog by the leash, they feel alliance with the owner. And I know, Hal, you hate those life analogies, but here is the one. Mm-hmm. Do you know why Iranian dog is so aggressive to American Mastiff? Because Russian bear and Chinese Akita staying behind him. If they would be not staying, if they would not staying behind, he would not be aggressive to American Mastiff. I'm talking about Iranian dog. So the same thing comes to your situation. I just give it more so you people would understand better. Once the owner just let the dog go, in a lot of times, there is no fight. So, but we don't know about this scenario. So that would be my first question to ask the people. Did they witness dog fight? And if the answer is no, and he just showing aggressiveness on the leash to another dogs, for me, that would be, he have a leash aggression, and he needs to be corrected on the leash, and he needs to be refocused. You need to really train him to be focused on you. So he'll be worried about the owner and not worry about the dogs, and he would be ignoring the dogs first, and after you can create positive reinforcement as you're passing another dog and giving the treats, and from that point of view, you can put the muzzle and get him into the dog park, and if he gets an aggressive behavior, you can basically do corrections and stop him by using or pet convincer. Sometimes we're using electronic collars for these things. And from that time, we will go from there. But we don't know yet. Regarding the humans, if you have a problem to the humans, more or to the dogs?
Okay. Well, here's the real bottom line, which you probably didn't hear this initial part in my original phone call, but they now have a child who is 2 months old. And they have been aware, as we have in our family too, of incidences where pretty even well-kept dogs have attacked little babies when something goes wrong.
This is very serious. You have to make sure that your dog and child sleeps together. Every time when the child, and I will explain what it is, every time when the child approaching to the child, as far, how old is the child?
Child is now 2 months old.
Yeah, 2 months old. So we're really running out of time, but I have to tell you, because it's many questions you ask at the same time, but in this particular situation, the best with my advice to you would be, if you can convince the dog, if that child smells funny, moves funny, or act funny, but it's a good thing, because I always get something out of it when the child is around, and I'm totally ignored by the owners. When the child is not around, he will perceive it as the good thing. For instance, having the child and going to the dog backyard, toss the ball, create the fun when the child is around. And many other things I can help you out if you contact me directly as well, which is SoCalDogTraining.com.
Okay.
Thank you for your call.
And I want, and I need, and I love. Vinnie Penn, the party animal, coming back at you. And I was at a friend's house the other night, just moved in with a new girl. And we're sitting at the kitchen table, having a couple of beers, having a good time. All of a sudden, her cat just hops up on the table. It's just allowed to just walk across this table. I've heard of this before. I've heard of certain cat owners who are like, you know, the cat can do whatever it wants. It's allowed to walk right across the counter and step right over your sandwich, for God's sake. I know she would have French kissed the cat if the cat came up to her and was so inclined to slip that sandpaper tongue into her owner's mouth. But, you know, I'm just sitting at the table and it's like, do you wipe it down afterwards? You know, if you guys throw a bag of chips here, is this cat going to be allowed to like walk right by me and plug right into the bag and have as much food as it wants? The worst part is this girl's got a kid. The kid came walking into the room and she said, don't come in here tracking your mud off of the sneakers. Now, let me get this right. This animal that has just been pleasuring itself and doing who knows what else around the house and down in the basement and in the wall and wherever else can walk across the area where you eat your breakfast, lunch, and dinner. But your son can't walk into the kitchen with his shoes on. What is going on with cat owners? Imagine if the dog jumped up on the table like that and walked across the table like that. What would there be? Absolute pandemonium. But this is yet another cat owner who has decided she runs the house. I think it's funny. She's a diva. That's what she was saying that night. She's a diva. Your cat's a diva. I thought we as a society really were kind of anti-diva. I thought we didn't like divas. But when it comes to cats, we admire it. We admire their brazen attitudes. I won't be back to that house for a bite to eat. And if I will, I'm going to be the guest over there wearing latex gloves when Monday Night Football starts up. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. I'm Vinnie Penn, party animal, Animal Radio.
This portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by Canipure. Now, here's a product you shouldn't live without. I use hand sanitizer, especially when I can't wash my hands. Now I use Pedipure Natural Pet Sanitizer when I can't bathe my dog. And finally, an antibacterial product for pets. Pedipure kills germs and odors to keep you and your pet healthy. Go to PurePaws, purehome.com now to get your free trial, damn it.
Do you know how important that is? A lot of people don't realize. Do you know, I knew a woman whose dog just went outside for a walk and picked up Parvo.
Wow.
and brought it into the house. And she was a breeder, and she lost a whole litter of puppies because just by walking in outside. So something like this is really important.
Yeah, let's give out that website again. I was just going to pass it by until Joey just mentioned it. Get PurePaws, purehome.com for your free trial. I didn't say that with a smile. PurePaws, purehome.com for your free trial.
Well, there's a golfer in Florida who yelled more than four when he lost his ball. I'm sure he yelled some four-letter words, too, because he met something very unlikely in that pond when he went fishing for the ball. Uh-oh. I'll tell you all about it coming up on Animal Radio News.
He lost ball or balls? I didn't get it.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll have to stick around and find out. Coming up in just a few minutes, Gary Burghoff, radar from MASH, will be joining us for the Season of Stars, a great animal lover, a fine gentleman. And also details on the Diamond Food Recall. It has been expanded to the Chicken Soup for the Pet Lover's Soul line, as well as the Diamond Naturals Lamb Meal and Rice Formula. All recalled. We'll have details right around the corner.
This is an Animal Radio News update brought to you by Pets Life Oral Care. Now there's a healthy and natural solution to prevent oral disease in your pet with no brushing required.
I'm Stacey Cohen for Animal Radio. Diamond Pet Foods has expanded a salmonella-related dog food recall that began in April to include its Diamond Puppy Formula. After recalling the company's Diamond Naturals Lamb Meal and Rice Formula Dry Dog Food and Chicken Soup for the Pet Lover's Soul Adult Light Formula Dry Dog Food in April, Diamond is recalling yet another dog food product after sampling revealed it too tested positive for salmonella. Also remember, you gotta wash your hands after you touch dog food, because if it does have the salmonella, you can become contaminated as well. Well, it looks like the bad dog of the neighborhoods received a life prison sentence. The wolf-dog hybrid named Chief, who was once ordered destroyed for his aggressive behavior, is going to become a guard dog at Louisiana's maximum security prison. Euthanasia was ordered for Chief last month after his neighbors in Point Coupe Parish testified that the dog would frequently escape from his owner's property and then terrorize them. Well, Deputy Warden Bruce Dodd said that prison officials read about the dog and they decided he could have a productive life if he guarded the perimeter of the 18,000-acre prison farm at Angola. That's so good because it, you know, gives a dog, pardon the expression, but another leash on life. Huh, leash instead of lease, get that? Anyway, I'm glad he's got a job. Good for him. When a black bear climbed a tree in central Arkansas City and refused to come down, authorities turned to unconventional rescue tools. They used a bouncy house, you know, those things from kids' birthday parties that they bounce in. Foster the Bear, named for the residential street where he was holed up on a tree, wouldn't budge from his branch. So authorities turned to a local hardware store whose owner rents inflatable houses and castles for kids' birthday parties. Well, they asked him to set up two of the bouncy contraptions beneath the tree. Then wildlife officials shot the bear with tranquilizer darts. Well, he'd slide down one side and the other. We're like, uh-oh, he's going to come down. He's coming down. Conway Police Spokeswoman Latresha Woodruff said. And then he'd balance himself again. Well, finally, Foster passed out, but he still didn't come down from his perch. Eventually, firefighters turned a hose on him until he tumbled down on the edge of the inflatable below. The bear, who was about a year old, wasn't hurt, though. He did land in between a blow-up castle and the other inflatable house, kind of like if you get stuck between a wall and a bed. Anyway, spectators who had been watching the bear in the tree for hours cheered and clapped, Woodruff said. Foster was fine, just a little knocked out. Wildlife officials are releasing the bear into the Ozark Mountains, where he will live happily ever after. I'm Stacy Cohen. Get more animal breaking news at Animal Radio.
This has been an Animal Radio News Update brought to you by Pets Life Oral Care. Our pets can show signs of oral disease by age 3. Pets Life is the healthy and natural solution with no brushing required. Visit PetsLife.com. That's Pets with a Z.com. Did you know that 80% of dogs show signs of oral disease by age 3 and the cost to fix these issues can be up to $1,000? Now there's a healthy, natural, and affordable solution, and no brushing is required. Pets Life Oral Care breaks down the plaque and tartar that leads to gum disease and bad breath. To avoid those large vet bills and keep your pet healthy, call 888-453-4682. That's 888-453-4682. Or visit PetsLife.com. That's Pets with a Z.com.
It's Animal Radio, celebrating our connection with our pets. 1-866-405-8405. That is toll free to any one of the Dream Team. Dr. Debbie, answering your vet medical questions. Vladdy, the world famous Russian dog wizard. Dog father Joey Villani. And animal communicator Joy Turner. And I must share what Vladdy just said during the break. He said, you know what? I think Dr. Debbie and Joey, animal communicator Joy Turner and me would make a great show. And I happen to agree. That's a great... So we've decided to continue this thing that we've been doing for 11 years right here on this fine station in XM Satellite Radio. Also, I wanted to give you a heads up. You may remember several months back, TLC, the Learning Channel, came in studio to film us for a show called I Cloned My Pet. That's going to be airing Monday night. So you want to set your TiVo for TLC, the TLC channel. That's a cable network. 10 p.m. Pacific and Eastern. That's Monday night, the 21st, 10 p.m. Pacific and Eastern on TLC. So you get to see what we all look like. And it ain't pretty. Just a few minutes. Gary Burghoff will be joining us for the Season of Stars. And I just mentioned a few minutes ago about the Diamond Food recall. It's getting huge. I believe it's salmonella that they're worried about. And there have been a few sicknesses, about 14 sicknesses from it thus far. It affects the chicken soup for the Pet Lover's Soul brand of food. And it just goes to show us once again that the food that we get on our shelves can be crap. And that leads to our next guest, Rick Woodford. He is the author of Feed Your Best Friend Better. And they call him the dog food dude. Hey, dude, welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
So how did you decide that you needed to start cooking better for your dog?
Well, my dog, Jackson, was diagnosed with lymphoma. and they said, you got maybe 9-12 months. And Jackson didn't seem have the same opinion. He felt like he had a shorter time. He wouldn't walk, wouldn't eat, didn't want to play. He kind of just gave up. And so I said, all right, buddy, if you're going out, you're going out in style. And so I just started feeding him food, and I didn't know what I was doing, so he got fat. But he did start moving around, started eating, started playing with the puppy. He started running with us again. So after about 18 months, the veterinarian said, I started learning how to slim him down and what I really should be feeding him. And the veterinarian said, I don't know what it is, but you don't need to bring him back. He's doing fantastic. And wow. I said, what's the food?
Wow.
And she said, well, it couldn't be. You don't know what you're doing. And I said, no, you don't know what I'm doing. I'm a nerd. I went to the nth degree on this. And so I started a dog food company, and my specialty was feeding very, very sick dogs. I did a lot of research to figure out how to do it and, like, what they need. I kind of cheat off of the vitamin mineral analysis of what commercial foods do, but I do it all with fresh foods.
You know, when I think
and
about...
Jackson, wait, one more thing I got to tell you. Jackson lived for 4 years cancer-free.
Oh, well, that's
it
great.
It was fantastic. So I had 3 extra years with my best friend.
Congratulations on that. You know, when I think about making food for my dog, a couple of things. I think it's going to be expensive, and I think it's going to be a big time suck. It's going to consume a lot of my time to do that. That's not necessarily true, is it?
No, and that's kind of what I did. I kind of took the angle of this book differently. For one, the recipes don't say it feeds 30-pound dog. I did kind of a larger size batch that makes like between 12 and 14 cups of different recipes. And there are things you know how to do. The meatloafs or a stew in a slow cooker.
Sure.
So you put it in, chop up a few ingredients, put it in the slow cooker, come back in 8 hours after work and you have food. I try to make it really easy.
Could you give us at least quickly one recipe? What today I'm going to get up. I get up at 6-7 o'clock, and we have just 1 hour for everything, and I need to cook for my dog. What would I do?
Okay, how about this? Let's say you're it's up in the morning and you ran out of dog food. One of my favorite recipes is Mother Hubbard eggs and oatmeal.
Okay.
And it's what do you do when you run out of dog food? It's very simple, eggs, oatmeal, and a choice of vegetables or fruit.
Eggs, oatmeal, and a choice of vegetables or fruit.
And see,
and oil,
I'm always worried that I'm not going to do a balanced diet. I know there's vitamins and minerals. I'm afraid if they get too much of one and not another.
You cannot cook for the hell, Judy.
Well, it depends on what you do. The approach I really recommend is a 50-50 approach, half commercial, half homemade. That way it's easier on you, it's easy on your dog, and commercial foods are so heavily supplemented that your dog is going to get enough nutrition because the fresh foods you're feeding are not going to come to the bowl empty-handed. They're loaded with vitamins and minerals, plus they have all the phytochemicals and antioxidants, and that's what really ensures good health. Mm.
Yes, I totally agree with that. To have a great commercial dog food as the base and add on top of it, you said, like eggs, whatever, fruit, vegetables, whatever, blueberry I give to my dog, everything.
Yep.
And oil, yes, oil.
Yep.
Yeah.
I like fish oil for dogs. It helps their skin and coat condition immensely.
There's a bunch of foods that we eat that we can share with our animals that are pretty healthy. What are those?
One of my favorites is blueberry pancakes. Dogs love them.
Wow.
And most of the foods that we like for ourselves are great because they're loaded with a little bit of salt, some pepper, onions, and those are the three things that are probably the three primary foods that we can't share with our dogs out of our meals. But things like fresh meat, vegetables, man. One of my favorite sections in the book is all about sharing foods right off the cutting board and how much is appropriate for various sized dogs. So for every single recipe and every single food, I tell you how much to feed a 10, 20, 40, 60, and 80-pound dog. Because feeding a Yorkie is a lot different than feeding a German Shepherd.
Okay. The book is called Feed Your Best Friend Better, Easy Nutritious Meals for Treats and Treats for Dogs. The author, Rick Woodford, the dog food dude. And I have 10 copies to give away right now at 1-866-405-8405. If you don't get through, you're not lucky enough to get through, it's on the Andrew McNeil Publishing label, and you can get that at your bookstore or order it online at Amazon.com. Good book, and it's very well done. Very colorful book. I love it.
Thank you.
Thanks so much for joining us today.
I really appreciate it. It was fun.
We're going to head back to the phones at 1-866-405-8405. Wow, Wall has really loaded us down with all kinds of good stuff to give away. This week, Joey Villani, again in his hands, the Deluxe Pro Series kit, putting him out of business. And you're not upset about that, are you?
You know what? I'm ready to retire anyway. So no, I'm not upset about it. But they definitely are. Making it real easy for everyone to basically groom their own dogs. And they got this Deluxe Pro Series Clipper here, which is it's cordless or corded, whatever you want to do. It has a real powerful drive. It has these comb attachments that you could slap on, and you could adjust the length of the coat. So if you want to keep long hair on, or you want to just bald it right down, you could do that. Comes with a DVD that tells you how to do it. Some oil to keep the blade oiled, which is really important. A lot of people don't think so, but it's special oil, and you need that. And a cool kit, a comb, and a mirror.
Wow.
What's better than that?
It's all one kit. Everything you need, including the DVD. And self-sharpening blades. I don't know how they do their self-sharpening blades, but apparently...
You know, neither do I, but I wish that all professional companies had self-sharpening blades, but it might put them out of business if they did.
I'm going to check out the DVD after the show. Apparently, it tells you how to do this so that you can be just like Joey Volani, except without the accent.
What accent?
Let's give one of these away. It's the Deluxe Pro Series kit from Wall. Our friends at Wall have one for you, especially if you adopt animals or you work at a shelter. And your job is to make these animals look really, really, really good so they get adopted. Why don't you give us a call right now at 1-866-405-8405, and the Deluxe Pro Series kit is yours.
This is Animal Radio.
Warm weather is here, and your dog is ready to trade in its winter coat for a summer haircut. Wall Pet Clippers are the number one home grooming choice for dogs and their owners, because Wall's precision ground blades cut hair without pulling or snagging. Grooming your dog at home is safe, easy, and it helps you save money. So show how much you care. Cut your dog's hair with a Wall Clipper. Visit Wall, WAHLPet.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Garvey, and I'm here with my good friend, actor, and pet food guru, Dick Van Patten.
Hiya, Steve. It's good to see you.
Dick, my two dogs have been on your Natural Balance for years. They love it. They look great. So what's the secret?
It's simple. Our formulas are developed by top nutritionists and based on scientific fact. And then they're made with the best ingredients.
It's just a winning combination.
It is. Just like Russell to Lopes to Garvey.
Thanks for that. Hey, everyone. If you love your pets like I love mine... try Natural Balance.
Kempton Hotels, the very first hotel company to welcome pets, goes beyond just allowing them to stay. Their Kempton Pets program includes pet-friendly perks like plush beds, bowls, treats, with services such as dog walking and pet sitting. Kempton has no restrictions for size, weight, or type of animal, and charges zero fees or deposits for pets to stay. So when you travel with your pet to New York, Chicago, Los Angeles, or other major U.S. cities, stay at Kempton Hotels. Find us on Facebook or KemptonHotels.com.
Animal Radio, toll free, 1-866-405-8405. And we just heard a call a few minutes ago from a guy who had to save up his money for a luxating patella surgery, and that's why I encourage you to think about insurance for your animal, especially at $1 a day. Isn't your animal worth $1 a day? Learn more at Protect Your Bubble. Yeah, protectyourbubble.com. $1 a day. A lot of people think insurance is expensive. Not really. Let's head to line 4. We have a call. Is this for Vlade? Okay, we have Bob on the phone. Hey, Bob, how are you?
Hi, Bob. Hi, Bob. You like our show?
I do.
Wonderful, Bob. I love you without even seeing you. But let's make agreement. Look, I don't want to get myself in trouble. You know, if you're hearing the show, I always get myself in trouble. Sometimes because I exercise the freedom of speech in this country to the large extent. Sometimes I'm running out of time. So, producer, look at me. Watch me as a hawk. So, please... start your question just, and after I will ask you a few things what I need to ask, and I will, that time we're gonna utilize the time. We have a 5 minutes. So, go. How can I stop my dog?
I have a border collie that I would like to make come mandatory.
Love it. You're the man. You know, how can I, my dog collie come to me every time when I tell her come? That's what you're telling me.
Exactly.
People, dogs listen to us when nothing better to do. And a lot of times, people say, oh, my dog is okay when no distractions around. But when some distractions, they're gone. So what the Vladi teach, to teach the dog to do reinforced obedience training, to make them do something in the time when they would rather not, when the collie wants to chase the squirrel, or do another negative activities, or cat, or see another dog across the street. How are we going to do it? We're going to do it in 2-3 steps. Step number one, you got to go to the hardware store and get a 30-foot rope, like a shoelace rope, almost like a clothesline, but it's a rope. No plastic, very light, to give your dog feeling of being on its own. I will attach the end of that rope to your dog's collar. If it necessarily, I would use pinch collar. You can use plastic pinch collar, imitating doggy mama teeth. Depends of your dog personality and temperament. You go to the end of the line and just, you don't say sit, stay, do nothing. You let the dog run around. That means come command under any circumstances. The dog run around, playing, doing whatever you want, and you say, Heidi, come! But I want to say, Heidi, come! Not just, Heidi, come, wouldn't you mind? Heidi, come! And Heidi maybe says, Daddy, I'm not going to come. Or she has maybe exercising a new selective hearing. From that time, you're grabbing the end of the rope and snap her toward you. Remember, not the pull. Snap. Snap imitate what? Bite. Because you're using bite collar on the neck. She runs to you. You are not angry. Good girl. Good girl. And give her what? Treats. Nothing wrong, people, to use the treats and positive reinforcement in the dog training. You gotta use it as a reward, but not as the bribe. In other words, when the dog comes to you, it's okay to give. Once in a while, it calls variable schedule of reinforcement. Eventually, I'm gonna increase the distance and increase distractions. Like ask some of your relative or friends, maybe distract your dog and call her under that circumstances. A foolproof recall command under any circumstance, my friend. And thank you for calling us.
This portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by Pedipure. Let's face it, when we wear shoes, we clean up before we sit on the couch or crawl into bed. We even sanitize our hands to avoid germs, but we don't clean our lovely pets after walks? What the heck? Don't be an animal. Sanitize your pets with Pedipure all-natural antibacterial wipes and spray. Go to PurePaws, purehome.com for your free trial. And in fact, let's go ahead and give away some right now at 1-866-405-8405. Let's see. We're going to also take a call for Vlade right now. We have Robert on the phones. Hey, Robert.
I'm doing good. Calling you from Pensacola Beach, Florida.
Oh, I just recently was in Tampa, Florida. You guys have one of the best eye doctor in the country. I dealt with my dry eyes at his office, so I love the Florida. It reminds me my native country, Baku, in Azerbaijan, the same like a climate. I just love it. I just love it. Some people cannot take it. I love it. Look, Robert, thank you for calling me. I know you want to ask me about your dog. Let me tell you before you even you ask me the question. You go to the animal radio and you ask the Vladi, look, you're going to get concrete answer to your question. No ziggling, mingling. No being trying to politically correct.
What was that? Ziggling, miggling? What the heck?
It means he got it. He got it. It's a Russian slang. Don't worry about this. Okay. I didn't say anything bad yet, so you have to come down, have some tea, and just keep watching me. I see you keep your finger on the red button. That's okay. That's okay. It doesn't bother me because it's not going to stop me. Okay, Robert, how can I help you?
Well, I have two dachshunds, miniature dachshunds, and I have one, and ever since she's a puppy, when people come to the house, she's very aggressive, like she's going to take their leg off. And we've noticed it, particularly when people stand up or move their arms, and we don't know, it's very embarrassing. I mean, even okay. People she knows, I don't know how to get rid of that.
Okay, and I love you just straight to the point, guy. Robert, I'm passing the people's houses thousands times. in 5 countries around the world. So this is, and I know the breed traits, and I understand what you're dealing with. So I definitely can help you. First, for you and everyone who is listening, dachshunds, or we call among our professionals sausage dogs, they are biting Americans much more than any in other breeds in the world. Forget people about pit bulls. I mean, dachshunds are nuts. However, they don't make the headlines because, you know, so what? I mean, they just, they have a little teeth. So how can we help Robert to fix his problem? Of course, if I was his trainer, I would do a different way. But how can I give him that easy solution, that the magic wand he is waiting for when he called to the Vlad? And I have a few. Number one, I would... So you have a problem, just very quick, Robert, with one dachshund, yes?
It's only one. It's more aggressive, yeah. I think
okay.
The other one instigation barking, but it's mostly
But another one... Another one barks too, but doesn't bite. Okay, and I would, and please listen me, you got to get 2 open crates, not the one, okay, not the one. And you gotta arm yourself with a device, and please listen me, by name, Pet Convincer. You need to get now, Pet Convincer will not be enough, you need to get Pet Convincer Plus.
Okay, you know what we tried was a collar that sprayed citrus oil.
No. Please, Robert, I want to tell you a lot of things. Trust me, it's going to work. You just need to listen to me. I know you try many things. I got to tell you something that you never tried. Pet Convincer Plus. Color will not help because it needs to come from you. You're the bad cop. People are the good cops. And let me tell you how to do this. This is the air spray device. Comes from you. It's a handheld device. Pet Convincer Plus. You, somebody knock the door. Let's play it. Let's quickly. Hell, you're going to be a door. Knock the door, please.
Knock, knock, knock.
Okay. Okay, the dogs are like Russian AK-47 downtown Beirut. Okay, your action. Your action. Yeah, exactly. Enough is enough.
That's
democracy is
right
over. Exactly. Russians in town. Democracy is over. Here is the methods. You grab that Pet Convincer. Scream the magic word. And spray it. It comes very strong air blast toward the shoulder blade. Oh my gosh, they just, wow, they just stop. From that time, like a doggy mama bite, doggy mama lick, you say, good girls, good boy. Enough to tell them one command, preferably with Russian accent. In, it means in the crate, in. And yeah. They may tell you, screw you. So in this situation, you need to screw them. How? So before you'd even do that, I would attach little leashes around them, like very light leashes. So when you say them in and they don't, you step on the leashes and they're gonna fly in those crates with the speed of Russian satellite guided missile. Quickly. Put them in, close it up. People coming in, they open the door. One of your dachshunds maybe from the crate says, you jump back. You gotta act theatrically. You know, look, Robert, if I tell you push the button, anvil bump on your head. How many times
you
gonna push
spray?
The button?
When do I keep spraying it? Just beginning, when do I spray the spray in their face?
To the shoulder blade. Yeah. To the shoulder blade. And you can snap the crate too. Don't raise your hand, just sideways. Startle them.
He wants to know when, not where, when.
When they bark, apparently.
Okay.
At any noises may make, Robert. Any noises, you have to stop. You're the bad cop. Now.
Okay.
Now. And after that, you just smile like a doggy mama who bite, and now she lick. And you say, good girls. Now the
I'm
people coming in.
That.
Now the people come in. Listen up. Robert, it's not over. People come in.
Okay.
They are the good cops. You are giving them delicious treats, and that's gonna be something your dachshund would be ready to betray its own mother. I'm talking
right.
about
right.
really crazy things. I'm talking about. I'm talking. Not vodka or hell. I'm talking about hot dogs fried on the butter. I'm talking about liver fried. I mean, Polish kielbasa. Something
like
they would die for. But it must come from cellophane bag. They're approaching, they make that noise, they're giving your dog treats. You are the bad cop. You are some control them. When they were thinking they're in charge, people coming and giving them treats. You do a few times like this, ask them to leave the house and come back. After the third time, if you were motivational enough, you have nothing. The dogs start to worry about you much more. That's the key. It's called scientifically competing of stimulus. Now they worry about you. They don't worry about your strangers, the good things. You after can let them go, and they will be just fine. If somebody will show stress, you can use pet convincer from the distance. Thank you so much for calling to Animal Radio.
You're listening to Animal Radio. You can learn more at animalradio.com. Log on. Learn more.
Celebrating our connection with our pets. This is Animal Radio. Here are your hosts, Hal Abrams and Judy Francis.
And your dream team of experts, Dr. Debbie answering your vet medical questions, Vladi the world famous Russian dog wizard, dog father Joey Filani, and animal communicator Joy Turner, all here at your beck and call. Also, Stacey Cohn working extremely hard in the newsroom. What's going on, girlfriend?
Can't help it, but when you think of dolphins, you think of Flipper. Remember Flipper, the
sure,
TV show?
Sure.
Flipper. Remember that? I love that show. That was one of my favorite shows as a kid. But, you know, you think of dolphins as little, you know, placid animals that are sweet and happy. You can swim with them.
Sure.
And the whole bit. You don't think of them as bullies, right?
No.
But there's a dolphin that's being bullied in Southern California. I'll tell you about it coming up on Animal Radio News.
I can't wait. I'm going to stick around for that.
Just for that.
You know, I love dolphins, but I hated Flipper. I got to tell you.
You know, I didn't like Flipper either.
Oh,
I think he had a
come on,
Flipper,
guy.
Lassie. I didn't like all these faggy kids. You know, the kids were those little faggy kids with, and you know, and the animal saved them. I just couldn't watch it.
Oh, come on. The kid was always out there in his short, bare-chested, you know? I mean, come on.
You know what? Joey said what I was thinking and I wasn't going to say, so I'm glad to hear that here on Animal Radio.
Again, the opinions expressed here.
And you know, I have actually spoken with dolphins, and they tell me that sometimes if there is one that isn't quite right, they actually will attack that one and either try to drive it away or do away with it. It's kind of like
humans.
Yeah.
Like dogs, too.
Yeah.
Dogs.
Yeah.
And Vladi be the best to tell you that in the pack mentality.
Exactly. But I'm not just to tell you we can train our dogs the same way how we train dolphins. And I had some experience working with the dolphins, not as a head trainer, as a student, as assistant in the Caspi Sea, it's in Baku City where I was born. For our zoo. So when the so-called new way of the dog trainers come on the market and they start to promote, and many books wrote about, well, that's clicker training, and because all of them came, it's like in America, we always, in Russia, we always say every new thing is the well-forgotten one. So they came up with this cute idea about using the clicker for the dog training. But let's be very honest, people. What do we expect out of the dolphins? Do we expect to have a dolphin on the leash passing through another dolphin whose neighbor cat Kathy is having across the street, who may be a whore, but her dolphin is all out of control and barking at my dolphin. You know, no, we're just expecting them to do simple things. I mean, but we're expecting from the dog something else. So I don't buy it. We can train them the same way. You know, that is why I'm so successful, because I don't treat the dogs humanely or defendingly. I treat them caninely.
Oh, just like dogs. Like dogs would treat each other.
Exactly.
Yeah, that might have been a better show. the whore with the dolphin instead of the little faggy kid.
God.
Okay, out of control here.
Yes.
Hey, listen, in just a couple of minutes, we're going to have Gary Burghoff on for the season of Stars. Of course, Radar from MASH. He was always around. She's sort of like Ladybug, the studio stunt dog. You're always looking for Ladybug. And all you need to do is look between your legs. She's always standing there. Radar was that way. And he'll be joining us in just a few minutes right here on Animal Radio. Joey Villani and I were actually exfoliating in the bathroom prior to the show, but you should have seen both of us looking in the mirrors exfoliating ourselves.
TMI.
Were you together in the
yes.
same bathroom? I didn't see that.
Well, he was showing me how to exfoliate, because that's...
I know what he was showing you there in the bathroom.
Well,
you know,
she's going to be talking
suspicions.
About exfoliating today, right?
I don't even know what
yes.
that word means.
Yes, I'm talking about exfoliating today. We can show you two.
That means to Vladi. It means to remove the dead skin. You kind of scrub it with something a little
I
bit harsh
see.
To remove all the dead skin.
You need to teach the dumb Russian what that word means. You know. I'm just. Come on, guys. Using two complicated words for me. Where's my vodka?
Let's kick off this hour with giving away a Thunder shirt. If your dog or cat is afraid of noises, vet visits, or being left alone, Thunder shirt's constant gentle pressure is the simplest solution for calming them. It's easy to use, and it's drug-free, and it only costs $39.95. Pretty cheap. You can get yours at pet stores or at thundershirt.com, and we'll give one right now at 1-866-405-8405.
This is Animal Radio.
Celebrating our connection with our pets. This is Animal Radio. Here are your hosts, Al Abrams and Judy Francis.
And your dream team of experts, Dr. Debbie answering your vet medical questions, Vladdy the world famous Russian dog wizard, dog father Joey Volani, and animal communicator Joy Turner, all here at your beck and call. And Stacey Cohn working hard in the newsroom. You know, I say working hard, but she never works hard, do you? Coming up on the show today, of course, the season of stars continues with Gary Burghoff, Radar from MASH. And also, Joey Volani and I, we actually spent the morning exfoliating our faces in the bathroom here at Animal Radio, testing out a new theory that he has about how you can exfoliate your dog, and he'll be doing that in just a few minutes. So let's hit the phones, 1-866-405-8405. And hi, Tracy.
Hi.
Where are you calling from today?
I'm calling from Greenville, Tennessee.
Tracy, thank you for calling us. This is the Vladdy. Are you our permanent listener? You're listening to Animal Radio all the time?
Not right now. We're truck drivers. My husband and I are truck drivers, and we generally listen. We're out on the road.
I love truck drivers. Okay, my dear Tracy, what the problem are you dealing with? Could you start with a question, please?
Well, I'd like to find out what I should do about my dog that has separation anxiety, and when he does, he will urinate everywhere.
And are you talking about a dog who's in your truck or in your home?
Both. He goes in the truck with us, so he is mm-hmm. with us pretty much 24/7.
Okay.
And at home, but when we get out of the truck to go eat or take a shower or whatever, we come back, and he's made a mess
inside of the truck. And the same thing's happening in your house too, yes?
Yes. And,
what is the breed?
I'm sorry?
What is the breed? What breed?
It's a miniature dachshund. We have two of them.
Miniature dachshunds again. And you have two of them. And how old are they?
The one we're having a problem with will be 2 this month, and the other one will be 4 in August.
And where normally they are peeing? Outside or on the pee pads?
No, when we're in the truck, gets up in the front by the seat. When we're at home, he'll just pick a corner mm-hmm. anywhere. Okay. It's not, you know, not a certain area.
But it's very easier. So you got it. So you have a very specific places where they normally go. But the last piece of information, I'm going to give you a solution you're looking for. When normally you're expecting them to pee? Where? Outside, on the pee pads? Where?
Yeah, outside.
And that's what they do when you are home. Yes, you open the door and say, go party, girls, boys, whatever, and they do it. Yes, and when you're not home, that's happening.
Well, even when we're home, that one will do it. Now, my other one, we haven't had the first bit of problem with him. He never goes in the house unless it's an emergency, and he mm-hmm. never went in the truck. But this one, we can be in the house, and he could have just gone outside.
So, okay.
He'll come back in and do it.
Okay, so the second one doesn't have separation anxiety. Second one just has a housebreaking problem, and another one has it. Okay, so you have a little bit complicated situation, but that would be my general guidelines to resolve it. I would put them behind, you have to use two choices, or you gotta get the crate, two crates, or you are going to have some type of their barrier, so you could make one part of the room or some small piece of your property kind of gated. In the relationship to your truck, you can put some type of the net, so the dogs will not be able to jump on the front seat too. The secret to resolving this issue is at least for 1-2 weeks not allow them to continue this behavior. So, or when you're not home or you're not even watching them, I understand he went outside to pee and after he come back and pee it again. So what I would do when he come back regarding that dog, I will momentarily confine him. and after maybe take him back again. If he is going to the same spots and urinating and peeing, it means there is dissent there, or he right. used to pee in the same spot. So number one, remove the scent. I would use, if you use any house cleaner, please don't do that. Use like a product from the pet store, like Simple right. Solution, Petastic. Those two considering be one of the very best. After when it's totally dried up, here is the secret. Humans, like a dogs, don't like to pee and poop in the toilet as they eat. So we're not eating hamburger sitting on the toilet. So the dogs will never pee and poop in the area where they eat. So here is the secret. You gotta get 2, 3, 4 food bowls. You can even have a plates, like a plastic plates. Put in the area where they normally, after you're cleaning, of course, then in the area where you don't want to pee and poop. And even when they're finishing the eat, still keep the food there for a while. This is one, and they magically will not go in that area and pee and poop. In other two approaches, you can use double stick tape. Double stick tape. Or you can get from the PetSmart or Petco product by name Sticky Paws for cats. Sticky Paws for cats. Dogs hate when they have a losing control over their paws. You can put this tape anywhere where you don't want them to go. They're not going to go there. And the final one from the same stores, you can buy the product by name, Snappy Trainer. It's almost like a mouse trap, but it's designed for dogs. Very safe, very humane, never hurt your dog, but spook them. Snappy Trainer, and that's what also prohibiting the area for them go in the same spots. That would be my quick fix solutions. Thank you for calling to Animal Radio.
Thanks for your call at 1-866-405-8405 to connect with our dream team. This portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by Kimpton Hotels. If you think your pet is cute, and damn straight, we all think our pets are cute, enter them in the Kimpton Hotel's Paparazzi Pet Photo Contest to win the ultimate pet hospitality weekend. Airfare for two on JetBlue and a three-night stay at your choice of Kimpton Hotels. The pet-friendliest hotels across America, like in San Francisco, New York, L.A., Chicago, Dallas. Be sure to enter, by the way, before May 31st. That's the end of the contest. And if I won, let's see, where would I go? Maybe Miami. I take my pet to stay at the Epic Hotel or the Surfcomer Hotel, two of over 50 Kimpton hotels that are 100% pet-friendly with zero fees, no size or weight limits, and you can find out more about Kimpton's pet program by calling 1-888-KIMPTON.
Vinny Penn, your party animal. Want to talk to you about a little something called dog sitting. Girlfriend of mine is in town this summer. She gave me a new number to call her at. I said, oh, you're not staying with your folks? And she said, well, no, I'm dog sitting for the summer. I'm like, what do you mean dog sitting? Well, my friends went away. I'm staying in there. Well, you're house sitting then. I said to her, you're house sitting. And she's like, well, no, actually, I'm here for the dog. The dog is the priority. I'm like, so if the house is burning down, you run in, you save the dog. You don't run back in for anything else. The house is the dog is the number one priority. Are you going back in maybe for, you know, some documents, some trophies? House sitting, the people who live there, one of the guys is a doctor. Are you going in for any of his degrees on the walls or is it just the dog? She's like, Vinny, stop ranting and raving. Stop being the party animal. I'm sitting for the dog. And I said, well, why don't you just bring the dog to your house? Unacceptable by the owners. Dog needs to stay in its environment. And I'm like, well, what if that environment burns down as we just discussed? She's like, listen, I take the dog sitting very seriously. I said, are you being paid for the dog sitting? She's like, no, Vinny, they're friends. And herein came the best part. And I said, so all day long, you're just going to sit around and take care of this dog, take this dog for what? She's like, well, I love the dog. And I'm like, well, of course, I get that. We're all dog lovers. She's like, yeah, I'm just going to swim in the pool. And that's when I really decided, folks, and for my girlfriend, Doreen, who's listening, you're not dog sitting. And no, you're not house sitting. But you are, my dear, pool sitting.
This is Judy from Animal Radio. For months now, I've been telling you about the Stella and Chewy's dog food. Now I want to tell you about their cat food, made with 100% raw meat. And just like all Stella and Chewy's products, these dinners are made without grains, fillers, artificial preservatives, colorings, sugar, or salt. They come in four flavors: Chick Chick Chicken, Super Beefalicious, Charming Chicken and Beef, and Yummy Lickin' Salmon and Chicken. Visit their website at StellaAndChewy's.com. That's Chewy's, Chewy's.com.
Provide your pet protection from biting pests with an easy once-a-month application. Advantage 2 quickly kills fleas within 12 hours on cats and dogs. Canine Advantage 2, for dogs only, repels and kills ticks, fleas, mosquitoes, repels biting flies, and kills lice. Advantage 2 and Canine Advantage 2 are waterproof and kill all flea life stages. Advantage 2 and Canine Advantage 2 are available at your veterinarian or favorite pet specialty retailer and are registered trademarks of Bayer.
Do you love cleaning the litter box? I didn't think so. Fortunately, you can solve your litter box problems with a free bag of World's Best Cat Litter. It's the only litter that uses whole kernel corn to clump quick, scoop easy, and safely eliminate pet odors. And because it's made of 100% natural ingredients, World's Best Cat Litter is pet people and planet friendly. For a limited time, you can go hassle-free for free with a mail-in rebate. To get your free bag, visit www.worldsbestcatlitter.com/animalradio.
Animal Radio is brought to you by...
New from Bayer Animal Health. Advantage 2 quickly kills fleas within 12 hours. Canine Advantage 2 for dogs only repels and kills ticks, fleas, mosquitoes, repels biting flies, and kills lice. Both products are waterproof and kill all flea life stages. Advantage 2 and Canine Advantage 2 are registered trademarks of Bayer.
Radio, celebrating our connection with our pets. Grab your pets, bring them around the radio. This is your first week. Welcome. This portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by World's Best Cat Litter. Are you ready to solve your litter box problem? Switch on over to World's Best Cat Litter. It's the only litter that uses whole kernel corn to clump quick, scoop easy, and eliminate those nasty pet odors. It's guaranteed or your money back. And in fact, you can get a free bag by heading over to the website, www.worldsbestcatlitter.com/animalradio, and get a rebate form. Or you can call us right now at 1-866-405-8405. We have 9 17-pound bags that we need to get out of the studio here because they're in my way.
There's no room.
No room for them. So call us and we'll give you one of these bags right now. Let's see. We're going to line 6, and we don't even have a line 6. Line 5 and... Steve. Hey, Steve. Welcome.
Hey, Hal. What are you doing?
Hey, it's our over-opinionated truck driver. What's up, bud?
Just sitting here relaxing in Breezewood, Pennsylvania at the lovely TA Travel Center.
Oh, you got to love that. What's going on? I understand you want to talk to Dr. Debbie. Everything's okay, right?
Oh, yeah. Just got a couple questions. Our little Boston Terrier, Yaya Butterbean, she's got to keep creeping up all the time. You keep hearing about it with the luxating patella.
Okay, yeah.
And
what's going on with
about,
that?
Well, she started favoring her left rear leg about just over a month ago. And I got to looking at it when I got home for a week and playing around with her feet and checking to make sure there was nothing and just trying to... I couldn't find anything, so girlfriend took her to the vet. He didn't take any x-rays or nothing, but he manipulated her kneecap and he said he could feel it moving. And I was just wondering, would it be too much to wait about another 6 weeks to get the money together? Because he wants to do the surgery on her, about $500 to $700, he said.
That's pretty cheap.
Now, that is cheap. I got to say, depending on where you're located, that's very cheap in the Las Vegas metropolitan area, I'll tell you that. So is she actually limping? Is she having discomfort with the legs?
She'll be going up and down the steps, and she'll pick her little left leg up, and she'll go down the steps, or she'll be walking in the yard, fine, and then all of a sudden, pick it up, start walking again, and put it back down and walk again.
Okay. Yeah. So she is showing the typical signs of kind of that intermittent skip or the limp with the leg, where then in a few minutes they'll use it pretty normally. So, no, I don't think that waiting 5 to 6 weeks would be too much. There are some dogs that have a very severe, almost acute injury with the kneecap when it can be very painful. For those pets, I would definitely want to get to the surgery a little bit sooner. But it doesn't sound like she's in any major distress right now. So I think you've got some latitude with that. And, you know, the good thing is that some dogs don't need surgery. They may do fine and compensate and not really be clinically lame from this. It sounds like your baby's kind of in the middle road here, where you're seeing that limping on occasion. Hopefully if you intervene before too long, you won't get to that end stage where there's already some deforming that occurs with the lower bones in the leg, and where that can be a little bit more troublesome with arthritis in the long-term scheme of things.
Yeah, that's why we want to get things taken care of quick. And what do you think the chances of this happening to her right leg might be?
Oh, very highly. And because it is a inherited condition, it's usually present in both legs. There are some dogs that are out there and that don't read the anatomy books, and that won't happen. But for the good majority of them, yeah, it's very likely. Now, when your baby is under anesthesia, that actually can give us a good opportunity to do some good feeling there. And in many cases, we'll take x-rays or just use a good sedated exam to feel, because that will help to give us some degree of how severe we might have in the laxity of that kneecap, and what the likeliness is that we might need to address that. But if she's got a good leg to stand on right now, you get this one repaired, who knows, maybe even if she has mild problems in that other side, we don't always have to have surgery unless
I hate surgeries. Sometimes the doctor wants to push it to get the money out of it. I hate that.
Oh, Vlade, shut up, please.
I know.
This is a valid, and Steve has a valid concern here. So, I mean, there are times, Vlad, where I will agree with you, maybe things aren't necessary. But if this baby is limping, there is a genuine need for intervening in these conditions.
But how he can suggest surgery if there's no x-ray?
Hopefully before we're doing surgery, we're going to get an x-ray. The good thing with a patellar luxation is to detect it and to diagnose it, it's usually pretty easy. Most veterinarians, just through a physical exam, can diagnose it. Now, I agree. I would not want to go into surgery without the benefit of having an x-ray just to know what our confirmation looks like. But it can be diagnosed in a conversational way through a good veterinary exam.
Hey, one other quick question. I know, like, with the anesthesia and that, for the small, the short nose, the brachycephalic dogs.
Wow.
Brachycephalic.
Is that a little bit more dangerous than a regular dog?
Not necessarily. With a brachycephalic dog, there's a couple special concerns. And for those doggies, they generally have smushed-in faces. They can have smaller airways. But generally, when they're under anesthesia, what I always tell people is they're breathing the best they ever have in their whole life, because they have a nice, open, secure airway. So for me, it's not so much them being under. I'm very cautious with the induction phase of anesthesia and the recovery phase. But while they're under anesthesia, they actually, like I said, they're breathing 100% oxygen, and they are just loving that air exchange. It's when they're awake that they really struggle to get good breaths.
Thank you, Dr. Debbie, for going through that. You are one of the greatest vets. I just love listening to you guys every weekend. All you are great. And Vlade, you stay out of trouble.
That's right. It's very hard, but thank you for your wishes.
Thanks for your call,
Take
Steve.
Care.
Good luck with Butterbean on that. It was
Thank
Butterbean.
Thank you.
1-866-405-8405 to connect with any one of the Dream Team right here at Animal Radio.
See, you are very smart. You know a lot of things. That's very, very impressive what you just said. I underestimated you.
Well, she just came back from giving a cat an enema.
You better stay away.
Yeah, Dr. Debbie, always sensitive to the smells. How do I smell today? Am I smell adorable or bad? I always like to put French perfume before I sit down.
How
with
can you
your
smell
doctor.
Adorable?
It's better than my German Shepherd Mika. That's what would be adorable for me.
Well, you've been dealing with a lot of ruptures today, and I guess that's got to stink, huh?
Yeah,
what
we have had.
What eruptions means?
Ruptures. We've had all sorts of ruptures at the clinic. It just seems like we're having a trend. So we had a doggy with an ear infection who had a ruptured eardrum.
Wow.
And many people don't know chronic untreated infections can actually weaken the eardrum and rupture those. So
how does a dog get a ruptured eardrum?
Well, usually from infection. So dogs' ears are real deep. They're kind of like an L, so it's not like ours. So infection can kind of brew deep down and erode that eardrum. And hopefully once we got this guy's ears cleaned up, those eardrums will regenerate within about a month's time if it's not too bad. But yeah, we had a doggy with a ruptured cyst.
Ooh.
So very common. We think they're benign, but actually they can rupture, get infected, and require surgery. So
did you have a dog with the ruptured vagina or penis?
Not there.
Yeah.
Not quite. You know what he's thinking? The other rupture we had was a perineal hernia.
Oh, okay.
So it's kind of like a ruptured backside where the muscles kind of weaken down by the butt. And yeah, so perineal hernias are actually kind of a hernia in the butt tail area. Very common in intact male dogs.
Okay.
It's hormone-driven, so we neuter them to help prevent that and help to treat that. But, yeah, so that's a common problem as well, and usually due to doggies that strain with stool or urinary problems. So, yeah, all sorts of things rupturing around here. I hope the pipes around the clinic hold up.
Yeah. I wanted
a funny job you have,
It really is a very funny job. If you are a trucker or you live in the Las Vegas area, you got to find a good veterinarian. Think of Dr. Debbie. She's where are you located? Where's the office located?
We're in Northwest Las Vegas off of the 95 and Cheyenne. And actually, I do have a couple clients that are truckers because it's so convenient to get in and out of our area. So it's kind of interesting. I just saw a couple truckers last week.
And if you're looking for the great dog trainer in Southern California.
Always got to come back around.
Exactly. So Lottie would be your choice. SoCalDogTraining.com. You know, you always try to promote Dr. Baby, and I'm kind of a little bit jealous, hell. You know,
I understand, because we never promote you. We never talk about you. by the way, speaking of Las Vegas, I wanted to mention that this portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by Pets Day. It's a unique program for guests and their four-legged friends available at Flamingo, Bally's, and Harrah's Resorts in Las Vegas. It includes the food and the water dish, the sleeping mat, the dog treats, and specialty room service. For more information, head on over to Caesars.com/Pets Day Las Vegas. Tonight in Las Vegas, the two kings, the King of Rock and the King of Pop, of course, we know they're really dead, but are they doing a show in Las Vegas? $62 gets you in the door at the King's Room at the Rio. You can bring your dog, and hey, guess what? If your dog gets sick or eating all that room service menu, you just call up Dr. Debbie. She's right there down the street.
I love Caesar Milan. What did you mention, Caesar? It's under his guidelines?
No, Caesar's Palace. Caesar's Palace. It's a hotel in Las Vegas, big hotel in Las Vegas.
It's not Caesar Milan Palace?
No, it's not Caesar Milan.
But I love him anyway.
By the way, if you need a good dog trainer, SoCalDogTraining.com.
Thank you, Hal. You're so nice. It's so nice of you. I'm pulling compliment from you like a dentist pulling the teeth. Dr. David, please, a little bit, come close to me because, you know, I enjoy you today.
If you need a DJ during the weekend, you know, maybe you're having a bar mitzvah or a wedding, I'm here to do bar mitzvahs or weddings. Just get me at animalradio.com.
And if you need a good dog walker, I'm available, you know. Give me a call.
The dog walker? You cannot even walk your crazy chihuahua.
It's not a chihuahua, Bloody. I don't have a chihuahua.
As long as you have a little bit chihuahua's blood in her, for me it's chihuahua.
She has zilch. She has as much blood, chihuahua blood in her as Mika does.
Oh, really?
Yes, I keep telling you, she's not chihuahua.
Okay, so she's a good girl.
She's Jack Russell miniature pincher. A little bit of Maltese.
We're using this
The Maltese is good. The rest of them doesn't sound good to me either.
Using this multi-million dollar station to
vent.
We're going to go back to the phones next.
I'm not breedist of, colorist, whatever it is, but I just believe the breed, the certain breeds, is affecting their personality.
You're listening to Animal Radio. You can learn more at animalradio.com. Log on. Learn more.
Concierge desk, this is Amanda.
Yes, I can recommend a great place for a walk.
Imperial Palace and Rio in Las Vegas are rolling out four-star treatment for our four-legged friends. Our new pet stay program includes in-room accommodations for up to two dogs, food and water dishes, sleeping mat, dog treats, specialty room service menus, and more. The dog days are here. Book your stay at Caesars.com/PetStayLasVegas or call 800-427-7247.
This is an Animal Radio News Update brought to you by Pets Life Oral Care. Now there's a healthy and natural solution to prevent oral disease in your pet with no brushing required.
I'm Stacey Cohen for Animal Radio. Well, you know, bullying is all over the news. You can't turn on the TV or read a magazine or anything without hearing about bullying. You think about it with school kids, but you don't think about it with dolphins. There's a dolphin who spent some days trapped in Orange County's Bolsa Chica wetlands, and he could be there because he's a victim of bullying, and he's choosing to stay, according to mammal expert Peter Wallerstein. He said forcing this dolphin to move could be a death blow. The last thing we want to do is force a confrontation. Wallerstein said the dolphin's breathing rate is good. He's got a lot of fish to eat in Southern California wetlands. And as for the dolphin bullying, well, Wallerstein said it's not as rare as it may sound. People think they're happy, loving animals, but they've got a dark side, and they can be pretty aggressive with each other. So they're just letting him, you know, kind of work his way back out into the ocean when he feels comfortable and let it happen naturally. Some bomb-sniffing dogs trained to help fight terrorism, well, they're turning their noses towards something different, a different kind of target that kind of squirms and lays on its stomach. Burmese pythons in Florida's Everglades National Park. The dogs are members of Echo Dogs. It's a three-year-old collaboration at Alabama Auburn University between the science departments and the school's Canine Detection Research Institute. They train dogs to detect explosives. The dogs are really, really good, said Christina Romagosa, a biologist at Auburn. She said in a test of python detection in South Florida, the dogs could cover a search area 2.5 times faster than a person. You know, people can only see that the snake is there if they can see the snake. The dogs can smell the snake even if it's not visually apparent to us, she said. Todd Stury, he's an Auburn conservation biologist and also co-founder of this project, said many of the Echo dogs were temperamentally unsuitable for indoor explosive work, but they actually thrive outdoors searching for ecological targets. A Florida golfer has his buddies to thank for saving his life after he was nearly killed by an alligator. Can you imagine this? 75-year-old Albert Miller was trying to retrieve a wayward ball from his pond. You know, let the ball go. If it's in the pond, there's no use getting all wet and all dirty. That's my thought. It's just a ball. He was at this Lake Ashton Golf and Country Club when the 9-foot gator attacked. It came out of that pond, bit down on his leg, and nearly pulled him underwater. Miller said he never would have made it if his friends hadn't rushed to his aid. The gator had Miller waist deep in the water. When he suddenly let go, Miller was taken to the hospital, took 40 stitches to close the wound around his knee. Trappers caught and killed the gator and another 6-footer that was also lurking in that water hazard. Oh, horrible. Life-threatening, very scary. I'd never go back on a golf course again. I'm Stacey Cohen. Get more animal breaking news at animalradio.com.
This has been an Animal Radio News Update brought to you by Pets Life Oral Care. Our pets can show signs of oral disease by age 3. Pets Life is the healthy and natural solution with no brushing required. Visit PetsLife.com. That's Pets with a Z.com. Did you know that 80% of dogs show signs of oral disease by age 3, and the cost to fix these issues can be up to $1,000? Now there's a healthy, natural, and affordable solution, and no brushing is required. Pets Life Oral Care breaks down the plaque and tartar that leads to gum disease and bad breath. To avoid those large vet bills and keep your pet healthy, call 888-453-4682. That's 888-453-4682. Or visit PetsLife.com. That's Pets with a Z.com.
We've been waiting for this. Radar O'Reilly from MASH. Gary Burghoff, ladies and gentlemen. Hi, Gary.
Hi, Cal. How are you?
Very well. How are you doing?
I'm fine. I'm glad to hear that the show's still going.
Of course. Of course. It's doing very well. And, of course, you were one of the original guests on Animal Radio.
I was a pioneer.
Yes, you were. And you are a pioneer in almost everything that you do. I hear that you're doing a lot of RVing recently, huh?
Oh, yeah. Well, I don't fly. And I've been
using an RV for my business.
So, okay, so let me see what all you got going on. You're still doing some acting. Is it theater?
I just finished a play, yeah.
What play?
I did, let's see, I did The Last of the Red Hot Lovers up in Connecticut in October.
Is it fun to do that kind of stuff? You like doing theater?
It is, but you know something? I'm looking forward to retiring.
Are you?
I honestly am. I just would like to have my kids come and visit and just hang back. It's been a 36-year career.
Yes,
and everybody's always asking me, what are you doing now, as if I'm supposed to be doing something now, you know? And I just don't feel like I want to do anything now. I want a beautiful garden outside my RV window. You know, I own an RV site down in Florida. In fact, I own two of them.
And you're a spokesman for them, are you not?
I am. It's a place called Nature Coast Landing. Implied in the title is really what it's about. We're bordered by a nature preserve, wildlife preserve, and on one side, and on the other side is Highway 19 in Florida. And Nature Coast Landings is an RV community. It's not like a resort. It's not a campground. It's an RV community. Everybody owns their own sites. We do our own landscaping, and we enjoy the environment and the wildlife here.
Are there any transient, can you come for the weekend and visit?
Sure can, but be careful. If you stay a week, you'll stay a lifetime. That's what I tell people. It's just a lovely, quiet community, just far enough away from town to be surrounded by wildlife. And yet close enough for all the modern conveniences. So I just love it here.
Do people identify you as Radar O'Reilly, and do you like that or do you not like that?
Well, I don't mind. I like being identified as the actor who played him. But I think that I think people need a reality check if they think that I actually am that character and I go home to my Uncle Ed and my mom in Ottumwa, Iowa every night.
Yeah, but there is something that is kind of interesting. We had Ed Asner on, and he always plays these roles, or these macho roles, but he's a big animal lover. The one thing that I noticed with you is that there were actually some similarities between the character Radar O'Reilly and your love for animals. You really were brought up on a farm. And
well, I wasn't brought up on a farm.
Okay.
My father was vice president in charge of manufacturing in a clock factory.
Oh, really?
So, yeah, and my mother was a dancer, so I was not brought up. I'm not Radar O'Reilly. However, Larry Gelbart, our head writer, would come to our homes, and he would get to know us in such a way that he would marry certain elements of our life, and one of which was my love for animals. He saw in my backyard in Malibu, he saw I had a center there for ailing animals, you know, where I nursed them back to health. And people would bring me, I was licensed by the state to take in injured wildlife, see? So as soon as he saw that, about 2 weeks later, Radar had his animal sanctuary on the show. It was written in the script, so there were certain things, and I guess that kind of confuses people a little bit and say, well, he was that in real life, so everything else must be true.
As I remember the last time you were on Animal Radio, you did mention that you did not have a lot of friends, human two-legged friends, as a youngster, but you had lots of four-legged friends.
Well, I'm not sure that I didn't have too many two-legged friends. I can remember many, but I did have a propensity, I think it's genetic, to be honest with you. I had a sensitivity toward nature and animals, and that goes all the way back to the beginning. I can remember passing a family farm and seeing the geese all locked up in a pen, and I remember kidnapping the geese and putting them in my neighbor's pond. Goldfish pond, and much to the consternation of my parents and certainly the family farmer. But it just didn't seem right for geese not to be on water, and so I've always had this sensitivity, and I think that most people due to one degree or another.
What was your first experience with an animal that you made that connection, you looked into their eyes? And what kind of animal was it? What was your first experience?
Well, I think it was like most people, it was a domestic animal, and I think it was probably my first cat. Cats climb into bed with you, and they curl up next to you, and you can't help but to feel connected to them. And I think it was my first cat. His name was Flippy, and a fascinating cat, by the way. That cat would dive into that neighbor's pond and catch the goldfish.
Oh my God.
He was an actual swimming cat.
Cats usually haywater.
He was a very unusual cat. Of course, some species of cats, such as the jaguar, I think the ocelot, love water. And in fact, are fishing cats. So, who knows where the strain came from, originally, from this particular cat. But this was an amazing thing, and of course, my first dog, who became, my friend for the first 16 years of my life, my dog Patch.
Mm-hmm.
You can't forget bonds like that. And if, maybe the good Lord wanted the animals to become domestic so that we would be more sensitive to all living creatures, because domestic animals introduce us back into the environment. We need to stay connected to our environment. We can't just be machine people and watch television all the time. We have to stay connected or we'll lose it. What we appreciate, we will refuse to destroy. But if we are so devoid of contact with it, we will lose that appreciation.
Exactly.
Just remember that we all have a reason for being here. We all have a right to be here. But stay connected with the world that we were born into, the natural world. That's where there's a great deal of wisdom and a great deal of lessons that are true and real that we can draw from. Just enjoy it. Don't get too close. Don't encroach on it, But at any rate, I think that's it. Please stay connected to the environment.
There he is, Gary Burghoff on Animal Radio. More Animal Radio on the way. Stick around.
This is Animal Radio.
What dog food is specifically designed to reduce the risk of cancer, settle digestive upsets, reduce scratching and shedding? Canine caviar. What dog food reduces red tear stains and hot spots? Canine caviar. What dog food has probiotics that reduce the chance of soft stools and have a higher calorie count for better nutrient absorption? Canine caviar. So what are you feeding your dog? If you didn't answer Canine Caviar, visit caninecaviar.com today and get your pet started on a longer, healthier life.
Why read a newspaper in the age of the internet? Because you take the time to think things through, like your love of animals. You want to know where your voice and donations can be most effective. Animal People is the newspaper for people who care enough about animals to give real thought to how best to help animals. Request your free sample copy at www.animalpeoplenews.org.
Fido Friendly is the travel and lifestyle magazine for you and your dog. Each issue includes hotel and destination reviews along with health and wellness topics, dog training tips, and the latest fashion trends. Pick up a copy at Borders, Barnes & Noble, Hastings, or go online to FidoFriendly.com and subscribe today. Fido Friendly is the only magazine dedicated to the travel and lifestyle of man's best friend and the one magazine your dog will thank you for.
You're listening to Animal Radio.
This portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by Wall. Dogs are one of the most intelligent animals, damn straight. You see, Ladybug, you know that. It's no wonder why Wall pet clippers are the number one choice of dogs and their owners. Wall blades provide better grooming results, and you'll look smart for saving money. Visit their website at Wahl, WAHL, pet.com. And ladies and gentlemen, I present to you dog father Joey Villani.
So, did you guys notice they're showing reruns of Groomer Has It, season 2?
Oh, are
so
they?
I want everyone to know that, yes.
On Animal Planet?
That's on Animal Planet. I just found that out last week. And because of that, you know what? It gets me excited. So, I my tip is very exciting today.
Your tip is very exciting. It really
it's
is.
Very exciting, it's a very exciting tip today, and I'll tell you why. Because it can save a lot of heartache to a lot of dogs if it's the problem. Now, how many dogs have, I don't know if you've ever seen it, but I know there's a lot of people out there listening whose dogs have dry, itchy, flaky skin.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, and I'm gonna say flaky because that's the key word right here. It could be a lot of underlining problems, but it also could be just a very simple fix, okay? Basically, what you want to do is, it's like we basically have to do with our skin. Every now and then, it's good to exfoliate. It's healthy. It also, you know, regenerates new skin cells.
I just exfoliated this morning, in fact.
Me too, actually. See that? We think alike. Yes, I did. As a matter of fact, I used the tip that I'm going to tell you guys is what I use, because I said if it works for the dogs, let me try it.
Okay.
Anyway, what you're going to do, you're going to get a quarter cup of brown sugar. It doesn't matter if it's light brown sugar, dark brown sugar, coarse, fine. Just get some brown sugar. What you're going to add to that is 2 tablespoons of either olive oil or avocado oil. Those two are very nourishing for a pet's skin. It absorbs better. Vegetable oils do not absorb into a pet's skin as good as olive oil and as good as the avocado oil. Now don't forget, most dogs do not have pores in their skin. So anything that you put on sometimes will sit on top and won't absorb as quickly. So this type of oil absorbs quickly. Now what you're going to do is you're going to make the mixture up, you're going to stir it up, and you're going to apply it to the dog's coat. And what you want to do is you want to separate the coat so you can see the skin, apply a little, and massage it in. Most times the dog is going to like it. Now, definitely have them tied somewhere that they're not going to run through your house, otherwise you're going to have oil and sugar all through your house.
Did you have to learn that the hard way?
You know what? I did learn it the hard way because I thought it would be easy, and somebody rang the doorbell and the dogs ran up the stairs and then ran to the front door, and you know, I ended up having to clean everything. You're going to rub it in real good, and then when you're done, there's 2 things you can do. If you're not planning on bathing your dog, because it's not real heavily, 2 tablespoons of oil, unless it's a real small dog, isn't going to be all that much. You could take the dog out in the yard and you could brush it out, okay? And it may be a little oily, but not too bad. It'll eventually absorb in. If you're going to bathe your dog, which is the best way to do it, then bathe your dog with any type of good pet shampoo afterwards. It's going to exfoliate the skin, but more importantly, around the hair follicle. It's going to promote healthy hair growth, and it's also going to nourish your dog's skin where they're not itchy and scratchy. If it comes right back after that, then it might be another underlying problem where you should talk to a veterinarian. But if you did this once every 6 weeks or so, it would really help your dog's skin and coat.
There you go. Your tip of the week from Joey Villani, the dog father.
Hi, this is Doug Gray of the Marshall Tucker Band, and forever you'll always be listening to Animal Radio. Keep loving those pets.
Animal Radio is brought to you by Natural Balance Pet Food, the finest food you can buy for the health of your pet. No matter which line of Natural Balance Pet Food you choose, you know it will truly be the food for a lifetime. Visit www.naturalbalance.net to learn more.
You love your pets, but should anything ever happen to your furry friend, could you really afford it? With pet insurance from ProtectYourBubble.com, you can get up to 90% reimbursement for covered charges. Use any licensed vet and cancel at any time. Let us help you care for your pet with pet insurance that covers accidents and illnesses. Visit ProtectYourBubble.com for a quick quote or call us at 855-792-7387. That's 855-792-7387. Underwritten by United States Fire Insurance Company. Coverage may vary by state.
Wanted to give you a heads up. You may remember several months back, TLC, the Learning Channel, came in studio to film us for a show called I Cloned My Pet. That's going to be airing Monday night. So you want to set your TiVo for TLC, the TLC channel. That's a cable network. 10 p.m. Pacific and Eastern. That's Monday night, the 21st. 10 p.m. Pacific and Eastern on TLC. So you get to see what we all look like. And it ain't pretty. do you say we take a call for Vlad?
Yes, let's go.
Yeah, okay, we have a call for Vlad A, and Lois is joining us. Hi, Lois, please save us.
Hey, Lois, this is the Vladi. Tell me, why everyone is trying to be so politically correct? Everyone is afraid. Afraid to say no to the employees, afraid to say no to their dogs, say something extra on the radio. Just the Vladi is the fresh air on the radio, and they even punishing me
That's
for
what
that.
Fresh air smells like?
Okay, how can I help you?
All right, I have two female.
I like females.
Maltese.
I love a Maltese. That's my favorite. Okay. It's a lady's dogs. I love them. And ladies my best clients because husbands never homes because it's never a problem for them. So what type of the problem you can have with two beautiful Maltese, which must be problem-free?
No, they're not problem-free.
Oh, maybe peeing somewhere.
We're in the bedroom watching. I drive a truck, so when I'm home, I'm in the bedroom watching TV and brushing them out and everything. And every time my husband either walks by the bedroom door or he walks in the bedroom, day or night, they just take off barking. I mean, they really get all upset and bark and bark and bark.
Bark on your husband?
What's this?
Barking on your husband?
Yes, and the little, the Nikki, the six-year-old, that is his dog. She curls up with him.
Oh, my gosh.
And
okay. Do you have a boyfriend, too? Why they are, how old are you having them together with your husband? Do you have a new husband or what?
No.
You still have old? Okay. So how old is your dogs?
They're 5 years old and 6 years old.
Okay, and how long it's keep going on, the barking at your husband?
Well, I bawl them out and tell them to stop. They have to get at least one or two more barks, and then they quiet down. But he can go back out of the bedroom and come back in later, or he'll stay up late, watching TV. He'll come in and wakes me up. They just, like he's an intruder or something. It's unbelievable.
Do you like your husband? Sorry to asking you. I need to got KGB. I need to figure you do.
40 years, so yeah.
Okay, so you're gonna keep him. Okay. I hope your dogs are not sleeping in your bed. No.
Yes, they sleep with us.
Oh my gosh, Dr. Debbie, you see what's happening? I keep telling you.
Yeah, I can see it already.
Yeah. Look, what's happening is your dogs, you elevated their social status. You gave them the same privileges like you and your husband have. They can put their scent over your scent, over your husband's scent. And from their perspective, if somebody left the den, when they comes back, they can get back without fight. I had the same situation with police officer who couldn't even go pee because when he came back, his Rottweiler, who was laid down next to the bed with his wife, was attacking him. Of course, I asked him what was his gun, but that was the same situation, So my best of the best advice, please, dogs, it's like a man. If you allow somebody to sleep with you, they will never listen to you. So you know that. So what you need to do, your nice Maltese needs to sleep down somewhere. And that's what I would do. I would lock them at the area where your husband sleeps. I would put the gate there so they could not escape if it's possible. If it's not possible, I might be put in the beginning very nice and cute playpen and put the dog beds there. I don't need to even create them, but I kind of give them that room. And your husband needs to be the good cop. I would give him the best treats your dog gonna love, and he gonna sleep with those treats under pillow, and the first things in the morning, good girls, and give them their treats. No eye contact, just drop it. Don't try to impose his attention to them. Don't try to make it hard. You need to be disciplinary. At any time they barks, please get the device by name Pet Convincer. And you shoot the air. It's very humane. You will startle them from the bad behavior. He needs to be a good cop. 5 times per day, every time. Let's say if he knows he's going to come in, they're going to bark. He needs to make that noise like treats going to come with telephone back. It's called double conditioning by Russian academic Pavlov. So before they send the treats, they can hear that noise. When you're opening the dog food or treats, they know what is coming. So why don't he will moving back and forth with those, like, put it somewhere, you know, if you can reach it, there's cookies, and just drop it to them. He cannot discipline them. He cannot give direct eye contact. But you gotta be bad cop. You gotta use that pet convincer. He gonna do this. And remember, they needs to sleep together with him. He maybe needs to put them in the truck and a little bit get bonding, like pick up the milk from the store or something. If they run around in the vehicle, put them in the crate. But they needs to spend much time with him. He needs to be the one who's feeding your dog. And you needs to be the bad girl. That would be my best solution to start this process. And thank you for calling us.
Thank you so much.
And that's all we have time for today. Remember, you can grab us over at Facebook at Animal Radio or tweet us at Animal Radio or grab the Animal Radio app for iPhone or Android or just email us at yourvoice@animalradio.com. Pretty funny how emailing us now is old school. That's the old way to get in touch with us. Or I guess you can call us at 1-866-405-8405 all week long. We want to thank Gary Burghoff for joining us this week. Next week, Ed Asner will be joining us. From all of us here at Animal Radio, have a great week. We'll see you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
This is Animal Radio Network.